Hi, everybody. Good afternoon. I'm Don Jenkins. I recognize some of you. I was just telling Cameron and Mary that I'm here representing the Friends of the Library. Some of you know that. You've seen me before. The Friends of the Boyden Library are happy to let you know that we are sponsoring this concert today. We're glad you came. We like to enhance and add some extras to the library program. It's a great library. We do dozens of children's programs and adult programs, but these are my favorites on Sunday afternoon. And I think some of you like them too. I've seen you here dancing in your seats before.
Oh, yeah.
But we'll hear more from Cameron and Mary in just a minute. They've assured me they'll tell us their story and everything about them. I always like to hear that. And they are new leaves. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it's a point of contention, our name. It kind of comes and goes.
Ah.
We'll play a song and introduce ourselves more.
2, 3, 4. Go away from my window. At your own chosen speed. I am not the one you want, babe. I am not the one you need. You say you're looking for someone who's never weak, but always strong, to protect you and defend you, whether you are right or wrong. Someone to open each and every door. But it ain't me, babe. Oh, no, 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 it ain't me, babe. It ain't me you're looking for, babe. Go lightly from the ledge, babe. Go lightly on the ground. I am not the one you want, babe. I will only let you down. You say you're to part, someone to close his eyes for you, someone to close his heart, someone who'll die for you and more, but it ain't me, babe. Oh, no, 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 it ain't me, babe. It ain't me you're looking for, babe. We'll melt back in the night, babe. Everything is made of stone. There's nothing in here moving, and anyway, I'm not alone. You say you're looking for someone to pick you up each time you fall, to gather flowers constantly, and to come each time you call. A love of your life and nothing more. But it ain't me, babe. Oh, no, 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 it ain't me, babe. It ain't me you're looking for, babe.
Thank you. So, as they said, this is Cameron Sutphin. Cameron's a full-time musician, and my name's Mary Hastings, and I am not a full-time musician, but we are very good friends since high school over 10 years ago, and I sometimes join him for some fun and wonderful Sunday afternoons.
She has a real job.
Yeah.
I don't. I get to play every day. It's fun.
But Cameron paid off his student loans before I did.
No, I didn't have any student loans.
Exactly.
I got out debt-free.
Does about 300 or so shows a year.
All right, let's do an Everly Brothers song.
Wake up, little Susie, wake up. Wake up, little Susie, wake up. We both fell asleep. Wake up, little Susie, and weep. The movie's over, it's 4 o'clock, and we're in trouble deep. Wake up, little Susie. up, little Susie. What we gonna tell you, Ma? What we gonna tell you, Pa? What we gonna tell our friends when they say, ooh la la, wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie. Now I told you, Ma, I'd have you home by 10. Well, Susie, it looks like we goofed again. Wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie. We gotta go home. Wake up, little Susie, wake up. Wake up, little Susie, wake up. The movie was so hot, it didn't have much of a plot. We fell asleep, our goose was cooked, our reputation shot. Wake up, little Susie, wake up, little Susie. What we gonna tell you, Ma? What we gonna tell you, Pa? What we gonna tell our friends when they say, ooh la la, wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie.
That's an Everly Brothers song. That song was a scandal. It was taken off the radio back in the 50s. And
it was.
It sure was.
A Boston radio station banned it for being too scandalous. And oh my, how far we've come. Listen to radio. Oh, it's awful.
So we're going to play a bunch of different things, but I hope that you know most of them. Cameron will do a couple of originals, but mostly folk music, country music, and then some
classic,
of our favorites.
Classic country. Don't worry. There'll be no hip-hop beats underneath with a banjo. That's what it is. We'll do classic country.
We like some of that, but not today.
Like this one. It's a John Denver song.
Mountains blowing like a breeze. and I started out in high school in a four-person band. You know, anybody in the school who didn't like all the rap music and heavy metal that was going on.
We grew up in Enfield, Connecticut. That's the suburbs. So I don't know why people got into hip-hop in the suburbs, but they did.
Yeah. But we moved to Concord, New Hampshire about a handful of years ago. I always knew I wanted to move there, and Cameron had spent some time in Nashville, Tennessee, and was done with that. And so we decided to move.
Then your entire family followed.
Yes.
And then some of my family is following next year.
They just, you know, like the snow and the cold.
All right. We're going to do a Harry Chapin song next. Arrived just the other day. He came through the world in the usual way, but there were planes to catch and bills to pay. He learned to walk while I was away, and he was talking before I knew it. And as he grew, he'd say, I'm gonna be like you, Dad. You know I'm gonna be like you. And the cats in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue, the man in the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know. We'll get together then. You know we'll have a good time then.
Well, my son turned 10 just the other day. He said, thanks for the ball, Dad, come on, let's play. Can you teach me to throw? Said, not today, but a lot to do. He said, that's okay. And he walked away, but his smile never did. He said, I'm gonna be like him, Dad. You know I'm gonna be.
Coming home, Dad, I don't know when. We'll get together then. You know we'll have a good time then. Well, he came from college just the other day. I'm so much like a man, I just had to say, son, I'm proud of you. Can you sit for a while? He shook his head and he said with a smile, what I'd really like, Dad, is to borrow the car keys. See you later, can I have them? Cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue, the man in the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when, but we'll get together then, Dad. You know we'll have a good time then. My son moved away. I called him up just the other day.
I said, I'd like to see you if you don't mind. He said, I'd love to, Dad, if I could find the time. You see, the new job's a hassle and the kids with the flu. But it's sure nice talking to you, Dad. It's been sure nice talking to you.
As I hung up the phone, it occurred to me, you're grown up just like me. My boy.
Cameron was actually lucky enough to meet Harry Chapin's band when I went away to college. Serves me right for going to college.
I went to college too. I went locally, so. Guy organizing it knew I liked Harry Chapin, said, hey, if you help them load in, which meant spending the whole day with them, you can get into the show for free. So that was fun. This next song, Mary's gonna sing, and this is one we play nursing homes in the afternoons and mornings, and that's how I have this full-time job. We were playing one near Boston, and one of the residents started singing this song as we were doing sound check, and Mary started singing it with her, and I went, we should do that one.
Well, I said, awesome, let's do it. And of course, this song makes me the most nervous because every 7-year-old sings it just perfectly. So, no pressure.
Here we go.
Argued about how we wanted to perform that song, though. I was Judy Garland all the way, Wizard of Oz, and he said that, well, and we both love the Oz's version, the Hawaiian man with his ukulele. Well, he combines that with Louis Armstrong's It's a Wonderful,
What a Wonderful,
what a wonderful world.
World.
Right, it's just gorgeous, so much fun. So Cameron said, why don't you do Judy Garland and I'll do whatever I want over here.
She's learning to play guitar, so at some point she'll be able to tell me specifically what she wants. This song, I have a CD over there that I made in Nashville in 2017. It's called Heartbreak Town. This is one of the tracks off of it. It's a 3-song CD, and I'm working on an album in Pittsfield, New Hampshire that'll be 10 tracks, and that'll be out either April or May. We're almost done. And this song called Drive, about traveling around the country. I've been to 30 states in D.C. performing. Yeah, I cover a lot of ground. The miles on my car prove that. This is called Drive.
Drive and drive.
songs and pick your guitar. Burn both ends of the candle like you don't care. If you fall, like you don't care if you fall. Show, they're over there for $5 or online wherever you download music.
He has one more later on that he'll perform, and it's one of the ones that he plays music for me all the time, and very often, as many musicians suffer through, I'm like, nah, put it away.
I have a 12-string guitar. I wrote a song on it I thought was the best thing ever I played for. She's like, no. You can do better. Go back to the drawing board.
But the one he'll play later, although it's not like a peppy song, it's not quite there yet. It was one I was like, play it again. Play it again. All right.
This is one I wish I wrote, but I didn't write. This is one by Woody Guthrie. All right. You'll know this one. Sing along. This is the folk portion of the concert.
Yesterday, And the whole audience, I felt like we should have done another round. They were so excited. But I was reading something the other day. It said, like, there was a list of 30 locations in the U.S., must-see places in the United States. And they said the average American will only see 3 to 5 of them in their lifetime. And I was reading through, and I already counted. I've been to 5. And I was like, how blessed am I? But yeah, I think some of them are like the Statue of Liberty and the Empire State Building and the Everglades in Florida, Walt Disney World, you know. So those are 4 right there. I forget what the 4th one was.
This is one that Mary's learning to play on guitar.
Yeah, I know the D chord, the G chord, the C chord, and kind of sort of how to put them all together. That's coming along.
So do
along.
You want, no, okay.
No. Sorry, no. I don't want to torture anyone. God forbid I add words to it. John Denver fan, something both of my parents always agreed on. But that was, I know most of you probably know Peter, Paul, and Mary who sang that one. Chops, that song took on a whole new meaning for me when I actually got on an airplane that took me to China for a year. I remember getting on the plane and that song was running through my head, and all five members of my immediate family were behind me, my parents, my three brothers, and I had my backpack on, and I was like, I started crying, and I was like, oh my God, I can't just stop this. You know, I'm committed, and I can't just turn around and come home when I get there. And yes, I was like, sometimes you have to get on that airplane, right? You have to go and have those new experiences, even though they're completely, totally scary. And then you come home and you're back where you belong, but you have more reasons to know why you belong there or something, you know.
I hate flying. Hate it. I hate heights, and I'm flying out to California for 4 days this year. So I'm willing to begrudgingly do it to travel. All right, Mary's going to do a Patsy Cline song.
Like her, but she was one of a kind. I didn't know who she was until high school when one of our band members sang that song, and then I learned.
Thanks. Well, this is Simon Garfunkel's song we learned in 2020 when I had time to kill.
Yeah. This was, I think I had the chorus stuck in my head, and only the chorus, and Cameron finally put his foot down and said, "That's it! I'm learning the whole song! And therefore, you have to, too."
I knew all the lyrics, I just didn't know the chords.
Yeah.
There we go.
We had a lot of time to kill on our hands all of a sudden.
Yeah.
2 years or so ago.
3 years ago. Three years to flatten the curve.
Wow. Time flies.
Sitting in a railway station, got a ticket for my destination. On a tour of one-night stands, my suitcase and guitar in hand, and every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band. Homeward bound, I wish I was. Days an endless stream of cigarettes and magazines. And each town looks the same to me, the movie.
every stranger's face I see reminds me that I long to be.
I'll sing my songs again, I'll play the game and pretend.
But all my words come back to me in shades of mediocrity, like emptiness and harmony. I need someone to comfort me. My love lies waiting silently for me. Silently for me.
You can see how that would get annoying, you know, silently for me. And of course, I'm not like really into the song, I'm just doing dishes. Silently for me. Tired of it real quick.
I do so many dishes, I'm kidding. All right, this is a Leonard Cohen song. There was a great documentary on this song, Hallelujah, and I rented it on YouTube for like $3 when it came out because I wanted to see it was about how he wrote the song Hallelujah. And then this month on Netflix it said new movie documentary, and I said I should have been patient. I could have gotten it for free. Because I'm still stealing my parents' Netflix account. My brother and I found a workaround for that, despite the fact that we're in our 20s.
I'm so glad you watched that and could tell me about it.
Oh, yes. I've watched a bunch of music documentaries. And I typically take a cat. That's what the cats don't care what I watch. They're cool like that. Her bathing on the roof and her beauty in the moonlight overthrew your. She tied you to a kitchen chair, she broke your throat and she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the Hallelujah.
time when you'd let me know what's really going on below. But now you never show that to me, do ya? Remember when I moved in you and the holy dove he was moving to, and every breath we drew was hallelujah. 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 Now I know there's a God above, but all I ever learned from love was how to shoot at someone who outdrew me on.
Talking about loop, but we can all make up our own stories, right? Cameron told me once that there were 80 verses to that song. I believed it. It turned out that he was a liar.
I learned new information, and I learned new information. Then I watched a documentary, it was 120. Wow. I've also been told facts don't matter.
We only did five.
Mary's gonna do John Denver's song.
He humors me by throwing in all these John Denver ones.
People seem to like them too, so.
Do
another Johnny Cash song.
like, which one?
The only other one we have in the set. 1, 2, 3, 4.
We got Mary Little Fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been talking about Jackson ever since the fire went out. I'm going to Jackson. I'm going to mess around. I'm going to Jackson. Look out, Jackson Town.
Will you go on down to Jackson? Go ahead and break your helm. Go plant your hand to a big talking man and make a big fool of yourself. Yeah, you go to Jackson. Go comb your hair.
I'm going to Snowball Jackson.
Well, see if I care.
Now when I breeze into that city, all the people gonna stoop and bow. Hey, all them women gonna make me see just what they don't know how. I'm going to Jackson. You turn loose my coat.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to.
Well, goodbye is all she wrote. But they'll laugh at you in Jackson, and I'll be dancing on a ponytail. They'll lead you around town like a scalded hound, with your tail tucked between your legs. You go to Jackson, you big talking man, and I'll be waiting in Jackson.
Well, we got Mary Little Fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been talking about Jackson ever since the fire went out. We're going to Jackson, and that's a fact. Yeah, we're going to Jackson, ain't ever coming back.
Okay.
Not really. I don't know if you know this, folk singers. It's not like we're rock stars. This song, this is a Stevie Nicks and Don Henley song. And I found out, I've had long hair pretty much since middle school. And my dad said to me, I didn't know who Fleetwood Mac was, he said, you look like Lindsey Buckingham. I thought he was insulting me. I thought, and I said, Dad, why? He said, no, Lindsey Buckingham. He said, guys, Fleetwood Mac, you should check that band out. You'd like them. And then I was down that rabbit hole. And I saw Lindsey Buckingham live 2 years ago in Northampton. It was an amazing show.
Cameron got a guitar for Christmas in the eighth grade. And that was it. He knew exactly what he wanted to do with his life.
Then it was, have you finished all your homework? You're playing guitar. Oh, yeah, all of it. Spanish? Oh, yeah, no, that's not important. Math? That's not important.
Somehow he managed to be on the Honor Society in high school.
Somehow, that was...
By cheating.
She still wanted me thrown out for not doing community service,
yes,
on time.
Yes, I do.
But I got to walk with chords. College, not so much. College, I got out on a plea bargain. My grades were bad. Because I was playing. I had all my classes in the a.m. and then I would go play in the afternoon and evening.
I can hold a grudge.
Gotta let that go. It's not healthy.
Is love so fragile and the heart so hollow? Shatter with words. Impossible to follow. You're saying I'm fragile. I try not to be. I search only for something I can't see. I have my own life, and I am stronger than you know. into my house, then you won't be walking out the door.
Lovers forever, face to face, my city or mountain, stay with me, stay. Eyes, could you ever love a man like me? And you were right when I walked into your house and knew I'd never want to leave. Oh, sometimes I'm a strong man, sometimes cold and scared, sometimes I cry. But that time I saw you, I knew that you would light my nights. Somehow I'd get by. Lovers forever, face to face, my city or mountain, stay with me, stay.
I need you to love me, I need you to stay.
Give to me your love.
And more than I want to know about that band. Cameron keeps me informed. But if you want to go on Jeopardy or something, and the genre is music, you want him by your side.
And I could win Jeopardy if it was just that. Then they're like great pieces of literature. I'm like, nope, I have no clue.
If it was religion, you'd do good too.
Yep, that.
But only those two.
Those two, that's it. Anything else, I'm done. Birds of North America, forget it. I'm just gonna walk off the stage and go, nope, I'm not winning.
Birds of North America.
I don't know. I don't watch a lot of Jeopardy, but I remember there being some category about birds or nature.
I could help with that.
This is a song that's not on that CD over there. It's gonna be on the one I'm working on. It's called Part of Me, and this song is called Mansion on a Hill. This is the only song I wrote in college that I still perform. Because all the rest were not good.
Lives in that home. I
just want to live in that mansion right here. I want to live in that mansion on the hill, where no pain or suffering lie. I want to live in that mansion on the hill, where only happiness dwells.
About a home in our, a house in our hometown. Cameron said, that's a nice looking house. And I think it was your mom, right?
And my mom said, yeah, but they have a lot of problems. Yeah. I used to get more specific as to what they did for a living, and then somebody, I was doing a show near Boston, somebody said, oh, you mean the house on Shaker Road? I went, nope.
But you wouldn't say the name of the street, Cameron.
It's not the house on Shaker. It's different.
Oh, okay.
It's not that. So I went, nope, not that one, but you're far too close. Wanted to that's the way to say goodbye.
Sure.
Do another Leonard Cohen one. This is off of his debut album, Songs of Leonard Cohen. And my mother told me that when she was younger, he was a poet, and she read his poetry, and her mother, my grandmother, didn't like the poster she had in her room of his poetry because my grandmother said, that's so depressing, it's too dark. So you wonder where I get the dark songs from.
I don't wonder. You said Bruce Springsteen didn't write a happy song until his late 30s.
That is true.
So you've got time.
I loved you in the morning, our kisses deep and warm. Your hair upon the pillow like a sleepy golden storm. Many love before us, I know we are not new. In city and in forest, they smile like me and you. Now it's come to distances, and both of us must try. Your eyes are soft with sorrow. Hey, that's no way to say.
Time for one more song. Thanks for spending your afternoon with us. We really appreciate it a lot. It's a lot more fun when the audience shows up. It's true.
I got to get out of work early today and come play music, so it makes my day great.
We have the CDs over there and cards. You can find me Cameron Sutphin Music on Facebook and Instagram, and that's where you get all my solo shows and our duo shows as well. And that's the only social media pitch I'm gonna make because I have to be on there. So thank you so much again.
Bye, my love, goodbye.
There goes my baby with someone new. She sure looks happy, I sure am blue.
She was my baby till he stepped in. Goodbye to romance, what might have been. Bye, bye, love. Bye, bye, happiness. Hello. My love, goodbye. I'm through with romance. I'm through with love. I'm through with counting the stars above. And here's the reason that I'm so free. My loving baby is through with me. Bye bye, love. Bye bye, happiness. Hello, loneliness. I think I'm going to cry. Bye bye, love. Bye bye, sweet caress. Hello, emptiness. Feel like I could die. Bye my love, goodbye. Bye my love, goodbye. Bye my love, goodbye.
Everyone, thank safe
you.
Travels.
Thanks
back
for coming
to where
out.
You come from. Enjoy your rest of your day. Thank you. My hands are so cold, I don't know why. I can't run them.
That is fine.